Hello guys and welcome to Xtream Droid. My name is Samir and as you can see that I am holding a Redmi 2 Prime which is running on latest Android 6.0.1 Marshmallow. The ROM was released by Resurrection ROM developers and they are saying that it is an official build, so you will get future updates. First, let me show you its Android version which is 6.0.1. In this video, I am going to show you how to install this ROM and a quick review that how this ROM is performing. So let's get started. To install this ROM, you need two files. First is the ROM zip file and the other one is gapps. I will leave the links in the description. Now before installing the ROM, your battery should be 60% charged and you should have a custom recovery installed like CWM or TWRP. If you don't know how to install a custom recovery, just click the above link. I had made a separate video for that. Now let's start the installation. If you are on MIUI, just go to Updater app and click the 3-dot button and select Reboot Phone to Recovery Mode. This will boot your phone into recovery mode. Before flashing your ROM, just make a backup of your ROM in case anything went wrong. Now select Wipe Data and swipe right to wipe your full data. Then go back and click Install and select your ROM zip file. Then swipe right to confirm the flash. It will take some time, so just wait. Once it is done, go back and select gapps package and flash it. Then click Reboot System. Now the first boot will take about 5 to 10 minutes, so just wait till the boot get finished. Now set up your device and enjoy the flavor of Marshmallow. Now let's talk about the performance of the ROM. I am testing this ROM since 3 days and so far so good, everything is working perfectly fine. The look and UI of this ROM is very lenient. If you like the stock experience of Android, then you will definitely going to love this. On the other hand, this ROM is very customizable. You can change every single aspect of your device. Talking about its battery performance, the battery optimization is really awesome, thanks to the doze mode. On full charge, the battery can last about 1.5 days with normal usage. You can also enable the root access. The Super SU app is inbuilt. Just click About Phone, tap the build number 7 times. Now in Developer option, click Root Access and select Apps and ADB to enable the root access. Now let's see how camera is performing. When you install this ROM, you will see that there are two camera apps. The first one is the stock camera and the other camera is Cyanogen mode camera. The Cyanogen mode camera is performing very good. You can take some decent images and videos. Moving forward to the sound quality, which is more than what I expected. The speaker as well as earbud performance is very good. The speaker is loud and clear. You can watch movies and listen songs without any problem. You can also customize the sound output by using audio effects as per your requirement. Now after all that, let's have a look over the bugs. I did not find any major bug, but if you are using the stock camera, it will crash sometime and sometime Wi-Fi automatically get disconnected, but the mobile data is working perfectly fine. And as you know that this ROM is officially supported, so these bugs will be fixed in the coming weeks, so you don't have to worry. So guys, if you like this video, click the subscribe button for more videos. You can subscribe to my channel. I will see you in my next video.